Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to tonight's production of Mixed Nuts. We request that all beepers and cellular phones be turned off at this time. Also, flash photography is prohibited while the performance is in progress, as multiple flashes are distracting to the performers. There will be one intermission tonight, at which time you may move about the theater freely. However, we ask that you remain in your seats while performers are on stage. In the event of an emergency, please exit the theater through the lighted exit to your right or through the rear doors from which you entered. There are to be no food or drinks in the auditorium at any time. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the Pisgah High School Drama Department presents Mixed Nuts.
Behind this door is a pathway to imagination, a parallel world not unlike our own. Our journey begins on an ordinary day in 1980.
Welcome to the Twilight Zone.
Spreading the news. I'm leaving. wondering why you let a giant olive into your apartment. Okay, I'm an actor. I'm doing kind of a street theater piece this afternoon in Times Square. I'm jumping into a giant martini glass from the top of the Allied Chemical Building. We're plugging a new brand of gin. Pretty original idea, don't you think?
Did you just hear a scream?
Yeah, it was nothing. Anyway, I'm getting paid $200 for it, and a case of that gin. Not that I put that kind of poison in my body or anything, but I could probably hustle it for a couple bucks. By the way, do you drink gin?
How can you be sure that scream was enough?
Don't lose your pants over it. It was only Tanya. She's a freelance ballerina.
Liz upstairs.
Screaming is a part of her therapy.
Rumor mill has it around the mailboxes. She's recovering from a fling with Baryshnikov.
Mikhail Baryshnikov?
No, Brad Baryshnikov. Did Edna tell you the story about the famous models here?
Well, she may have mentioned it in passing. What kind of therapy is screaming at the top of your lungs?
It's primal. You know, you try to report your most innermost feelings like screaming. Ah! Glad you got that. Oh, that jab. Woo! It was a lot easier on all of us when Tanya was into her transcendental meditation. Personally, I think she just likes to scream, and the therapy gives her reason to cut loose. So, got anything to eat in here? Ooh, can I eat this?
Sure. It might be a little mealy, though. I packed it before I left the date.
No problem, amigo. When you're a professional scrounger like me, you might eat anything. Joe, you never told me what you thought of my outfit. I don't think I ever caught your name, either.
I'm Michael Caldwell, and you look like an olive.
Great. But you know what? In here, I don't feel like an olive. No, seriously. I did this 2 years ago with Strasburg, and it took. I mean, it really took. Method acting had me becoming any part I play. When your specialty fruits and vegetables has its definite disadvantages. One time, I landed a part of one of the Fruit in the Fruit Loom underwear commercials. You know the ones I'm talking about. Anyway, I have mentality and social disposition of a Concord Greek. This is the first time I let myself play a vegetable in a year. Well, I think I can handle it. $200, I think I can make myself handle it.
Let me get this straight. Your specialty as an actor is playing vegetables
and fruit. It's not easy getting legitimate work. You know, it pays. That's what counts, though. So, did you just get in?
Yeah, about 3 days ago. I've been staying over at the Chelsea Hotel until I can find a place to live. This isn't exactly what I had in mind, but it has some character.
It also has some blood. Oh. You know, there are some cockroaches in my apartment that are so big they can pull up a chair and eat with me. So, where are you from?
From Dayton.
Yeah, I'm from Portland. Lived in L.A. for 5 years, but couldn't handle it. Too many oddballs. You know, next time I'm that laid back, I want to be dead. You know, you were lucky to get this apartment. The rent is so low.
I don't think the $400 a month is so low.
What? Look at the skyscraper. Look at the skyscraper. Well, did you happen to see a skyscraper when you came in? This is Manhattan. $400 would normally get you a closet in most of these buildings.
Yeah, I guess you're right. So, you mind if I clear it for this?
Oh, no, yeah.
So, when did you come to New York?
5 years ago. I was in a play. I was in a road company up here at Broadway.
Never heard of it.
Yeah, you and everybody else. It tied to dismal death and dream. And we were all stranded. New York seemed a logical solution. So what, are you a writer or something like that? Look at Don. You know where Tiny comes from? Reading other people's mail for national sport. Well, better go get my mail. Nice talking to you, Michael. I'll be downstairs at 6 a.m. in the evening. Well, bye.
Well, good luck with your jump. And people say there are a lot of weirdos living in New York City.
Are we calling with just pass me in the hall, normal?
For Pete's sake, will you let me introduce myself before you arrive on the scene?
As I was saying, my name is Michael Caldwell. Michael Stoddard Caldwell, to be more precise.
Precision is one of his most annoying traits. I've been working on it for years.
I thought I left you back in Dayton.
Fat chance.
But one of my main reasons for leaving was to get away from you.
Don't whine. I hate it when you whine. If it wasn't for me, you wouldn't be here.
That's not true.
Sure is, and you know it. I get stuck with all this dirty work.
You're making me feel like a schizophrenic.
Oh, grow up. Everybody has another side to it. The only difference is yours talks back.
Yeah, what?
Not as much as I could. If you'd let me. Face it, you need me. I had to drag you down to the train station. If I didn't put my foot down, you'd see me run the bitch for the Dayton Press.
Yeah, well, it was better than working for that.
The man is a mortician. What's the difference? Don't you want to write about the living for a change?
I'm just scared, that's all. I mean, what if I don't have the talent?
I'm telling you, you've got to work on your self-image. Where's the bottle?
What bottle?
Well, you knock it off. It helped you sneak into the suitcase, remember? Ah, bliss. Too bad Mom isn't here to see a little boy in demon rum in action.
That's right! Drink! Just twist the knife in my heart! Oh.
Mother, I'm over 21, and one drink isn't going to put me under the table.
It has before. Remember?
No.
Yes?
When?
What is she talking about? Uncle Bud's wedding. We got so bomb we puked on man's wedding cake.
I was 6 years old.
So, even at that age, we should have known that drink would impress it. Don't cut it.
That's right. You won't listen to me. Listen to him. Whoever he is.
This is not New York. It's the Twilight Zone.
What do you mean,
whoever he is? He's me.
Why are you yelling at me, young man? None of this is my fault.
She's right. We are your fantasy.
I don't believe it. My imagination is ganging up on me.
Your guilt must be working overtime.
Well, I don't see why. I mean, it's not like I did anything wrong. I told her where I was going, didn't I? I really did. See, watch. Mother, I love you and Father very much, but I must go to New York. I do. It's for the best. A big city environment will help me grow as a writer.
Well, that's rational, isn't it?
It sure is. And it would have worked if Mom or Dad were rational.
It did work. I think.
Think again. Michael's mother has a slightly different version of how this scene just went. This is how it looked from her side. Mother, I'm going to New York whether you like it or not. I want to see small animals and eat lots of Indonesian food. I want to shoplift. And after that, I want to die a bump in the gutter having disgraced the Caldwell family name and wasted my life.
Oh my God!
You just broke the heart of the woman who gave you life.
I didn't.
You did. This is so confusing. Who is it?
Mostly.
Oh, don't know him. I've got
a good time to get to know one another. I mean, I just came in from Ohio and I'm really tired of it. You know what I mean?
I understand. You're saving up energy to make big moves. Is that what you were doing? Oh! Oh. Maybe later. It's time for Tiny to go talk to Blunt anyway. Oh, you're so cute.
I don't think I can take this much longer.
I thought she was a riot. Ninjitsky and drag.
Go away!
Well, this is beginning to look like a fun place to live. And you certainly aren't going to like anything to write about. That chick alone is a guaranteed novel.
And what is that supposed to mean?
Do I have to spell it out for you? This place, this environment is perfect. You don't even have to make anything up. In fact, you're not good enough making this up. I wonder what other nut burgers live in this joint.
Hope I don't have to find out tonight. I'm beat.
Don't be ridiculous. Get some paper for that typewriter and put this down before you forget it.
I don't think she'll flip my mind. Let me think about it, okay?
All right, you think about it, sport. My mind is made up. It's gonna be the story of the year.
Later. No, sir, not tonight. I was thinking more like tomorrow or the end of the week. Yes, sir, tomorrow.
Was it a good part?
I am 16, going on 22. No, it stinks, but it pays $300 a month. Not that the money is enough to compensate for the bill of acting at sea. Have you ever seen anything out there?
No, I just got into town.
You hadn't missed much. It couldn't be like mine. See, all the sets are floating barges, right? And they're pulled on and off by little tugboats. Remember Morty? He's one of the guys that steers the tugs. Good old Mort got just a bit high last night. The grand set in the second act. It was hilarious. Everywhere you look, there were drowning guns trying to pull themselves in with their rosary beads. What was that before it died?
My lunch.
Cheese ravioli on white bread. You should try the meat ravioli. It's better, trust me. I'm in it. So, how long have you been riding?
Oh, for several years.
Yeah, Marshall said you're from the Midwest somewhere. What'd you do?
Come to New York to find your fame and fortune?
There are 10 million stores in the naked city. This is one of them.
Well, I just...
Oh my God, you did. Well, let's take a look. The man came into the cafe. It was a dirty cafe. The dirt and grime filled his nostrils with the stench of despair and lost hope. Who you got your nerve
for? Oh.
Hasn't anyone told you that the person who best demonstrates simplicity of the Hemingway style is Hoffman himself?
You don't understand. It's supposed to be that way. I'm entering this literary contest.
Since when do they give the Pulitzer Prize for originality?
Harry's American Bar and Grill Ride Like Hemingway contest. It's named after a bar that Hemingway used to go to in Florence, Italy.
Oh, yeah? What do you get for winning?
They fly you to Florence for a meal at Harry's.
Just you?
No, come to think of it, they let you take a friend.
You did say Florence, Italy, right? This little piece will never make it. I've always wanted to go to Italy. Sit down and write what I tell you. The sun glinted off the snows of Kilimanjaro as the hunter left camp. The sun was also rising as he left. Far off in the distance, the hunter could see an old man on the sea.
Hey, you're pretty literate. I mean, for an actor.
What is that supposed to mean?
You know what they say about actors. You know, they're kind of flighty.
And all Orientals carry cameras. For your information, I have a master's in English Lit from Columbia.
Oh?
No. But I know the guy in the English department there. When it blew up, I dumped him and stole his books.
So, were you born in New York?
Over in Brooklyn, Bay Ridge.
Bay Ridge. That sounds pretty.
It's okay. My family's still there. The Italian Waltons of Bath Avenue.
Do you come from a large family?
Not by our standards, but to you, we're probably an emerging nation. 7 kids, and of course, our grandparents live with us, and then there's cousin Angela, who is 32 and still not married. God help her. Oh yeah, and Uncle Cheech. He used to drive for Al Capone. Seriously, the man is 78 years old and still has an unnatural fear of cement. What's your tribe like?
Oh, not nearly as colorful. They all live in Dayton. My mother, she's middle-aged.
Sounds like a real madcap.
Oh, but my father once had a letter published in Time magazine.
Brothers and sisters?
No, I'm an only child.
Are you the last of the Red Hot Coldwells? Does the fate of the family name rest on your frail shoulders?
Actually, my Aunt Allison and Uncle Bud have a son, Biff. He's about 16.
Biff? Oh, as in really low indebted salesman, Biff.
No, Biff is in my grandfather, Michael Bifferton Caldwell III.
I have never known a real guy who had a number attached to his name. Except Uncle Cheech. He got his things in. You know, against my better judgment, I'm suddenly finding your teen beat good looks minimally attractive.
Huh?
Read my lips. I like you. How about the two of us going to get some breakfast somewhere?
Oh, well, I would, but I mean, I just got
in. You can't make it. That's fine.
No, I mean, it's just that I came here.
No, really. I understand.
No, I mean, it's just that I'm not ready to be here with you. Yeah. Well, some other time?
No!
Wait,
why not?
What?
Why don't you want to go with me? What is so pressing here that you can't go? Or is it? No, it couldn't be. Me? That's ridiculous. Right? Right? What is it? Oh, I get it. Just come in from Indiana.
Oh, hi there.
Regardless. Anyway, you're standing there thinking to yourself, gee, here I am in New York in an unbelievable. Gee, just like you do, so well. Gee, if I go with her, I'll have made a complete fool out of myself being the unslick zero that I am. I'll wait till I get to know her and the city a little better, and I'll take her someplace that will compliment her certain je ne sais quoi. Her understated elegance. Am I right, Michael?
Well, actually...
Because if I'm not, there's only one other reason, that you're scared of me. You think you're one of those psychopaths you read about in the New York The World Successful articles, that I won't take you to breakfast, to club you to death in some subway bathroom with a curling iron? So to put your Midwestern mind at ease, I'll give you the capitalized version of Get to Know Philomena Delavicchia in 10 Easy Lessons. Sit down. Likes and dislikes. I like Ingrid Bergman movies, trench coats, following celebrities around New York, and chocolate. I think I like chocolate the best. My pet peeves are steak, Olivia Newton-John, all that blonde hair and blue eyes. And people label everything as Freudian. They're usually the same folks that say, have a nice day, and we're not relating. And that's great, because then I only have to avoid one large group of people. Stress energy. End of sermonette. Now, can we please go eat?
Do you always talk this much?
Going once, going twice.
Okay. And breakfast is on me.
I thought that was understood. And since I like you so much, I'm going to put you right in the center for tonight's performance.
Oh, gee, that would be swell.
Gee, that would be swell. Who are you, Andy Party?
No. Covered well.
Yeah, I'm talking about the Coast Guard with part of the chorus. You can't
pretty serious about a girl.
If I'd be spared nothing on this, my night of nights, now it's because of hot monkey laws of Dayton. What'd you do, take your proms?
Look, Phil, I was just trying to help you take your mind off things.
Okay, tell me about her.
No, forget it, never mind.
Oh, come on, I'm dying to know. What was her name?
Cindy Evans. She had blonde hair and blue eyes.
I bet you her hair in a ponytail is perpetually tan.
Yeah, how did you know?
Lucky guess. Does this get any better?
Yeah. Well, let's just say that we were pretty involved.
How involved?
Well, we were kind of engaged.
Engaged? Still waters do run deep. For how long?
I don't know. For all I know, we still are. Cindy doesn't exactly know that I'm in New York.
You ditched a girl named Cindy Evans who has blonde hair and blue eyes? What kind of animals do they breed in Ohio? Poor little twit. She's probably back home suffering from a terminal case of heartache. I mean, who's she going to get to take her to the country club dance on Saturday night? Anyway, were you in love with her?
Well, I asked her to marry me.
And what happened?
I'm not really sure. I mean, it wasn't anything she did, but it wasn't anything she didn't do. I don't know. I guess the problem was just me. Cindy once told me that...
What?
Cindy once told me that whenever we kissed, she felt like I wasn't there.
Sounds like a charming girl.
No, I knew what she meant, and she was right. My heart just wasn't in it. I can't explain it any better than that.
Then don't try.
Hey, you're the first person to ever say that to me. Thanks for understanding.
I didn't say I understood. I just mean you don't owe me an explanation.
Oh. Well, I just hope so that hate me. I mean, would you hate a guy if he did that to you?
I'd never let it get that far. But if I did, I'd be really mad. Yeah, anyway, what's the difference?
Well, I mean, I'm here and she's there.
And bullets don't travel that far.
So were you in love with the guy you dated?
Who, Eric? He told me I was. Picture this. He taught English lit at Columbia. He collected oriental rugs. He had a picture of Karl Marx on his office wall. And there were suede elbow patches on every article of clothing that he owned, including his pajamas. The guy wrote the book and I keep it stereotypes.
But if you thought he was so funny, then why did you date him?
At the time, I was impressed with the image. Things like suede elbow patches mean a lot when you're 18. And Eric was the first person to treat me like I had a functioning mind. It turned out I did. Let me give you one of my many examples. My agency once got me an audition to play the Princess Leia part in Star Wars. God alone knows how.
You're kidding. I love that movie. I must have seen it 6 times.
Yeah, well, you would have loved it even better if it would have been me in that rocket with Harrison Ford. But Eric said it was ridiculous for someone who was trying to establish herself as a serious actress to even consider a role like that. And I believed him, for which I am still kicking myself. Not to say I would have gotten the part, but who knows. Stranger things have happened.
So what did you do?
Wound up in a play on Bleecker Street that Eric wrote. It was experimental, which is theatrical euphemism for Looney Tunes. I sat in the playpen the whole first act repeating the word ambivalence.
Oh, wow.
As God is my witness, I don't know. When I asked Eric, he said it was a microscopic representation of the symbolic frustration of the blue-collar worker, which meant that he didn't know either.
Was that when you dumped him?
I should have, but I felt so sorry for him after the play closed after only one night. But I let it drag on. Then I found out he was seeing some co-ed transfer from Bennington. He claimed that she interested him and his work on a more higher level than I was ever capable of achieving. And that's when I dumped him.
Oh, look, I'm sorry, Phil.
Oh, c'est la vie. So, I know you hadn't been in New York a long time, but have you sold anything yet?
I wish.
Well, if you don't mind my asking, how are you supporting yourself? Running a numbers racket out of this joint?
No. I cashed in a trust fund that my grandfather left me the day I left Dayton. Not a whole lot, but it'll get me through the winter. After that, I don't know what I'll do.
Trust fund? What are you moaning about? The only thing my grandfather ever gave me was his union card.
Oh, look, Phil, I mean, if you need some money, I'll be glad to lend you.
Oh, God, Michael, I've got some savings. I'm just fetching. It's a hobby. Some people collect glass, I bet. I know I'm good at it, but I don't take it seriously. Some people bet you where you're from?
Vetch!
Where are you from, Mars?
No, Pleasant Acres.
Pleasant what? I thought you said you were from Ohio.
I am. Pleasant Acres is the name of the community we lived in there.
It sounds like a cemetery.
Yeah, I've often thought that's why we lived there. My family runs a funeral home chain.
Ew, gross.
Relax. I mean, we didn't bring the customers home with us.
If anything, I guess it's a steady job.
Michael, still in there?
Yeah, Marsh, I'm in here.
Are you decent?
What do you have in mind?
What?
You want the party? You want some coffee?
I don't have time.
have been canceled. They told me to tell you to pick up your severance pay in the morning. But I got you this. I knew you'd like it.
Look, she made the newspaper. Daily News photo section. It's a Night Owl edition. Where'd you learn to swim?
When the choice between that and swimming with the fishes, you learn fast. Let me see that.
Who's that guy you're trying to drown?
Morty. I wasn't trying to drown him, I was just trying to teach him a lesson.
Oh, sure. It's a good thing the Coast Guard was there to pull you off his back before it was too late.
Well, sorry about the show, Phil. So what are you going to do now?
Now I'm going to go home, where I will fill my bathtub with lots of nice, hot water. And there, I will open my bank.
No, that's Philomena Delavetti, I know love. Mwah!
Good guy, Michael. I'll see you tomorrow.
Well, let me know if something comes up.
You gonna make rounds in the morning, Marsh?
No. You remember that deodorant commercial I shot last April? Still giving me residuals.
Deodorant commercial? I'm not even gonna ask.
She must really be exhausted. So, was it as bad as the paper made it sound?
Well, it wasn't the Titanic, but it ranked right up there with the Andrea Doria.
So, what else happened? Did you get anywhere with Bill, huh?
No.
Don't feel bad, my friend. Few people ever do. Well, I better get running before my dates start getting anxious. See you tomorrow, Mike.
Go see you.
I just bet she's interested in me.
Forget it, chump. She's not your type.
And how would you know? You weren't there tonight. This is one terrific girl. She's smart, she's pretty, she's funny, and she knows about all kinds of things.
Like I said, not your type.
What am I, Frankenstein?
No, just an Eagle Scout from Dayton. Come off it, Caldwell, you're not really.
Thank you very much. I mean, I can be funny when I want to be.
Yeah, you're a million laughs.
I'm going to bed.
Don't forget the floss. I hope you don't take this too far. I think feels great and all, but you need something a little more low-key. Besides, you come to write, not date.
I just met her today.
Yeah, well, I've seen the signs before. You act like a stuffed animal in heat. When you face the facts for once, Bill's career comes first for right now. You heard what she said about that Eric guy. For crying out loud, the woman lost her job tonight, and the last thing she needs is you on her back. So stop fantasizing that anything's gonna happen. Do you hear me?
Well, I take it this Willy Wonka routine.
Why didn't you just take the commercial?
And Mr. Marshall lied over my apartment. I can't say it's his turn. This day should have been some type of war for rot.
Oh, come on, Phil. Your day couldn't have been that bad.
Thank you, God. My day is complete, Dan. A tableau of the Upper East Side.
Yo, Tonya, come on in.
Oh, my fingers dancing across the TV writer machine. Decide to come with it. Hello to you, Phil. Not working in again with the big candy?
Barbie Miss Perkin.
Yeah, I guess she does.
That's what I like, a woman with pride. So, are you going on the midnight train today, hmm?
Well, I don't know yet. I've not had a chance to answer her back.
Oh, come on, Caldwell. You've sold your story. Now you get back to Idaho, your thin chest covered with merit badges, and live the rest of your life out as a potato head.
For some reason, I have this eerie feeling that you're not in a good mood.
I'm in a great mood. I just had a little indigestion coming on.
What did you have for lunch today?
3 helpings of moo goo gratin and half an inch of pizza.
Sounds more like toxic food shock.
You got any Pepto?
Yeah, in the fridge.
What kind of person keeps Pepto in your refrigerator?
It's an old Ohio custom. Here, drink.
You know, Caldwell, you're really not bad of a guy. I mean, you put up with me, don't you?
Well, that's not so hard.
Okay, well, look, I'm sorry about this now. You're not mad, are you?
No, of course not.
Okay, well, then, meet me downstairs. Do me a favor. Bring the Pepto, will ya?
Yeah.
So, what are you going to tell when the story does come out? It's just coincidental. The setting is a high school lunatic! Those people are not lunatics. Michael, trust me. This place could be the uptown branch of Bellevue.
Don't you think you're being a little hard on them? I mean, those people are staying balanced adults.
I'm loving you, Courtney!
See what I mean?
Yeah, there's $10 in your khakis. Will you get serious? We're facing one of the greatest disasters of our time, and that article hits the stands. Orson Welles may have to narrate.
Look, you're making me late, so why don't you just stick an egg in your shoe and beat it?
Trey, funny. Did you write your own stuff?
Look, I'm sure that my harmless little satire will not cause weight.
What you just heard were the famous last words of a really nice guy.
Greta Garbo all over the streets last night, and she wouldn't even let me say hello.
You are so stupid. You're not supposed to touch her. There are rules, Michael.
I'm sorry. I can't do it, Bill. I'm taking a girl out to the Zeke Field. There's a big Marx Brothers festival.
Who'd you better go to this time, Boy Wonder?
It's a girl that plays a waitress at the cantina.
A waitress for what?
Take too long. Oh, Mike. That's what I was going to talk to you about. I could hook you up with one of my leftovers if you're interested.
Well, it depends.
On what? Is she humanoid? Don't trust him, Michael. Some of his leftovers violate the leash laws.
Shut up, Bill. We have a stewardess, a model, and the owner of the health food club across the street.
Nick.
I can answer for myself, Bill. What are their names?
We have Angelica, Heather, and Rainbow Sky Cloud.
She sounds like a weather report. Oh, wait. I know her. She's that 60s throwback. She doesn't wear shoes. Rather obvious call, but you have karma efficiency.
Any gorgeous brunette on your list?
Heather is sort of, you know, mom.
Well, she sounds cute.
Yeah, real cute. Just like a slim, fat button.
Well, here. Here's her phone number. I told you you'd be calling.
Isn't it a little bit short notice for a date?
Not for Heather. Hardy is her middle name.
Well, how did you know I'd pick her anyway?
I didn't. I got all their numbers and told them all you'd be calling. Well, I need to go pick up my costume. See you guys later.
Costume? Wait, I don't get it.
Maybe you will, if you wish real hard, Romeo. Well, aren't you going to call her?
Yeah, of course. I mean, why wouldn't I? It would be nice to get out for a change. Operator, give me PL96311. Beat it, Bill.
No way, Jose. I might learn something.
Bill, will you please get out of here? I'll talk to you later.
Hello, Heather.
Oh, sorry, sir. Is Heather there? That was her roommate, Mr. One.
I wonder if that's the same Mr. One who cuts my hair.
Hello, Heather. Yes, this is Michael Caldwell, a friend of Marshall Ryan. That's right. He said you might be interested in going on a date sometime, so I was wondering if you might be free tonight.
You are?
What a coincidence!
What?
Sorry, that was my roommate, Mr. Phil. Anyway, so I was wondering...
Hold on. Where's someplace nice I could take her?
The Four Seasons.
I thought the Four Seasons would be nice.
Okay, where can I pick you up?
All right, got it. I'll see you then. Bye-bye.
Well, how do you like them apples? Looks like Michael Stoddard Caldwell has a date with a fashion model.
You better call the restaurant and make reservations.
Reservations?
Yeah, it's one of those funny little New York habits that probably hasn't hit Dayton yet.
Oh. Well, how should I dress?
Nothing fancy, just wear your lady belt.
Wait, how fancy is this place?
I figure for the two of you, a decent meal would cost you somewhere in the area of $250.
What? Are you insane?
Well, that's wine included, of course. It's the most expensive place in town.
Oh, I don't have that kind of money.
I thought you wanted to show her a good time. Don't worry. I'm sure that fertile brain will come up with something. Whatever it is, say, Michael.
Oh!
Thank you.
up on a terrific date to do this. Not to mention the money I shelled out for this outfit.
You shelled out bucks for that track?
$25 to be exact, not to mention the money I paid for my date's harpal outfit.
It won't go to waste.
I don't like this, Bill.
Look, you owe me one. Didn't I go out with your cousin from Syracuse?
Harold is a nice guy.
Are you going to force it out of me? My image of Mr. Wright is not to pick someone with pink hair and a safety pin through.
Hey, is it my fault that punk rock just hit Syracuse, huh?
Just shut up. Help me with this.
No, Bill, not the dribble glasses. This is low, no.
It always works.
Yeah, but still.
Look, are you going to help me or not?
What are you looking for now? No, Bill, no. I will not be part of this. No way, no.
Marshall, get back here. Did I tell you that a friend of mine from Equity is marrying a director? He's doing a play at Circle in the Square?
So?
He can't start rehearsals because he can't find a good enough unknown male lead. He asked me if I knew him with the Guild. He trusts my intuition.
Did you happen to mention anyone we knew?
No, but I could. You know, you make me sick. Now, put this someplace obvious.
I don't understand why you're doing all this, Bill. I mean, it's not like you and Mike are... Wait. You and Mike are, you know, like... No, I can't believe it. No.
What don't you believe?
I just never thought of the two of you as, you know, like... Why don't you just tell them how you feel?
And set myself up for rejection.
Why would he reject you, huh? You're a great girl. You're smart. You're attractive. You're sensitive. Sort of. You don't have to come through this.
Are you a trust?
What?
Who is the person that just said these things to me? Where have you been hiding for the past 2 years?
Maybe I just had a temporary lapse into your humanity. What are you going to do, take away my birthday?
I'm just surprised, that's all.
What's this? Everybody but Marshall has feelings, Dave? If I'm cut, do I not bleed?
Let's find out.
Lay off, Bill, I bet you. I'm tired of being the man that's thrown around here. You don't have to take the abuse.
Say the answer specifically. Lay it right on the line and say, this is how it is, and what do you can do about it?
You can be a little more subtle. I know. Try it out on me.
Forget it.
No, seriously, I'll be Michael.
I should hope so. Joel Juan spent all afternoon contouring my cheekbones.
Why don't you sit down and make yourself comfortable?
Are you kidding me? Do you have any idea how long it took me to get into this outfit without wrinkling it? We were both dressed this way to be comfortable. Why do you think I stood the whole way over here on the subway train?
I was wondering about that. Your feet must be killing you.
I'm a model, silly. I'm used to my feet killing me. Let's just say it comes with the territory.
But you would have sat down if we stayed in Four Seasons.
Not necessarily.
How do you eat?
Who would have eaten? At a place like that, you just mingle. There's always so many interesting people to talk to. I told a lot of people I'd be there. Oh well, either or all, right? So, what do you think?
About what?
About the outfit. Since you're the only one who's going to see it, I'm wearing last month's issue of Harper Bazaar. Don't you just love the French sleeves? They're pure genius. Really is that, too. A part of the new pirate look. That session was great. In one shoot, I got to pose with a guy just like Bluebeard. He wore a kerchief with little bones and everything. It was wild.
Modeling must be, fun.
Oh, it is. But do not be misled. I mean, photography is such a very high art form. And, well, so much of it depends on me. If I'm not beautiful, everything's just ruined. Luckily, that's never been the problem.
Well, why don't you come sit down and have some sushi? I mean, I think it's getting cold.
It's supposed to be cold, silly. Haven't you ever had Japanese food before?
No, not really.
We should try it. It has proteins and vitamins and everything.
Vitamins?
Vitamins, silly. That's just the way Madame Fafoon says it. Although sometimes, I think he just says it that way for effect. But it is such a rush, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I just love men with English accents. Really, I do. Like once, I got to go to London, where I did this raincoat layout, and everyone told me these accents. It was like living with the Beatles or something. But they're kind of uppity about it. Like once, I told the bellhop outside my lift, that means elevator in English. I said, I just love your accent. And he looked at me and said, well, I don't have an accent, you do. And I don't know what he meant by that. But see what I mean about uppity? But I got over it. I guess a man with an English accent could just tell me to jump off a cliff and I'd do it. Don't you think that's funny? I wish you had one.
What?
An English accent. Haven't you been listening to me?
Sorry. Sounds like you modeled in some interesting places.
Oh, I have. Like once, I got to go to Barcelona. It was on my way to Rome, where I did a lingerie shoot at St. Peter's Square. Was that ever an experience? I mean, well, don't those Swiss guards ever see women? Foam in the mouth and everything. Right in front of the Pope. Uh-oh. You're not Catholic, are you?
No, I'm Methodist.
Really? Well, I was raised Mormon. But since then, we're in Buddhism. I went to a party once at a photographer's apartment. We wound up chanting all night. Did me and Trevor and then some. Everything just seemed so clear all of a sudden. Do you think my eyes are too far apart?
What?
I was once heavily involved with a guy who broke up with me because he said my eyes were too far apart. I mean, how superficial can you get? Because I know they're not. Is there any more sushi left?
Yeah.
Anyways, thinking back, I guess I gave you too much credit. I guess I should set aside that not everyone has the depth that I do. And that bothers some people.
What does?
The fact that I'm different. That really bothers average people. Oh well. At least I have Juwan who accepts me for the eccentric that I am.
Well, I don't see why anyone would give you such a hard time about it. I mean, I wouldn't say you're eccentric.
I am so eccentric! Well, everyone says I am. I looked it up. Eccentric means different. And I'm a lot better looking than most people. Oh, well. I'll survive. You know that song, I Will Survive? At first I was afraid! I was petrified! Kept thinking I could never live without you by my side. But then I spent so many nights thinking how you did me wrong and I grew strong. I learned how to get along until you're back. Yes, I am.
So, what do you plan to pursue?
Acting silly.
No, I mean like a theatrical career. Films?
Oh, well, it doesn't really matter to me. I just want to participate in something that will touch the lives of other people. Just between you and me, what I really want to get into is soaps.
Soaps like a palm olive?
No. Soaps like soap operas, silly. Don't you take any in?
No.
Well, you should. The things I've learned from those people, the problems they face, they're so real life. Makes you feel like you're not alone, you know? You're right. Right?
Right.
Well, I think that's just wonderful, you know why? I read all the time. Drives Jawad absolutely crazy. He spends most of his free time taking in high levels of sound. Music.
So, what kind of stuff do you read?
Oh, I read Harlequin, Ecstasy, Romance, Silhouette, all kinds of different stuff. Have you ever had Indonesian food before?
No. I've been meaning to for months, but there never seems to be enough time.
We should try it. It's a total food experience. I live off of it.
All the time?
Well, when I'm not fasting. But not just any Indonesian food. The best kind comes from the Outback.
The what?
The Outback. It's a place behind their city. Oh, well, the tribe on 2nd Avenue just opened up this new store. And it's totally vogue. Their pepper alone causes self-purification. Last week, after dinner, I found myself in the bathtub reliving my birth. And then I started to get really paranoid and I started crying and screaming for 6 hours. Ah! 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 It was great. And then I had to get my stomach pumped. Did your eye just twitch? Am I making you tense? Tension causes death, you know.
Well, we're all going to die anyway. Why not just help it along?
Now you're hostile. You've got to get rid of the hostility. You've got to stay. No way. No hostile vibes for me.
Leave her alone.
What are you doing?
I'm fighting for your honor, which is more than you ever did.
That's a good one, boss.
May I have a lock of your hair?
No!
You're lucky. I was going to ask you the whole way to move you.
Oh my gosh, what else I do?
I'd horsewhip you for that if I had a horse.
What?
Nothing. Forget it. Look, I'm sorry. Really, I am. Forgive me?
That depends. Do I have a choice?
No. Take me to breakfast, I'm smart.
No, you take me to breakfast. There's $17 in your wallet.
You look in my wallet?
Yeah. I've never seen so many charge cards. I was almost blinded by the reflection off the plastic.
Did you take anything?
Nothing. Although, I have to admit, your membership card to the Monkeys fan club was pretty tempting.
It'll be worth something someday.
Oh, sure. Is that why you kept a picture of Sonny Bono?
He came with a lot. And when you're Italian, there's some loyalties you can't afford to explain. Anything else you want to ridicule in here?
No, I think that about covers it.
Then where do you want to go eat?
Zabar's.
Zabar's?
Mm-hmm.
Just to breathe the cream cheese and lox in their cost.
Yep.
Oh, I get it. I'd like you to be with God for revenge.
Think again, Philomena. I'm going to eat you out of next month's rent.
I have you choked on the smallest thing you saw. 15 minutes?
30. I need to shower.
Okay, meet me at the elevator.
Phil!
Yeah?
You forgot God.
Right. That's a very strange girl.
Tell me about it.
Are you ready to come home now?
Are you kidding me? She's finally showing some interest.
That's what worries me. You don't want a girl like that.
Oh, yes, I do.
Then why? You had Cindy Evans and Dayton?
Mother, I realize you have my best interest at heart, but I'm not in love with Cindy Evans.
Oh, thank God. I hated her anyway.
But, honey, and I mean this with all my heart, I hate that one even more. She's so...
Italian.
That too. You're coming here.
It was a big, big mistake.
Another no.
But Mother, don't you want me to be happy?
Not as much as I want me to be happy. Shall I help you pack?
Keep your paws off the luggage, Toots.
It's him again.
Phil's the first one you've ever known that's worth the effort.
But why should he be the one that has to make all the effort?
That's right. Why should I?
Oh, it must have slipped your mind for a minute. You're in love with her. She's not yet in love with you.
If she's not in love with you, then what's keeping you here? I don't think she'd mind, even if you did come home.
I think she'd care.
Oh, yeah, she'd care. She'd cry her eyes out for about 30 seconds.
You're not going back to Dayton, are you?
No, of course not. But it would serve her right if I did. Don't be ridiculous. I mean, you're not gonna get that mad over this.
Thanks to him, I'm
probably going to lose the beer commercial. And the bee commercial. Not to mention all the other vegetables in my repertoire.
Do you actually think dressing like a moron is a vital contribution to the art?
Oh, and one you have lied on, Miss Sophia Loren. The last one you were in is at the bottom of Zach's Bay.
I've come for you, Mr. Caldwell.
Why not everyone else, Adam?
Frank Holmes, go and say, go and purchase that and review. Can you go? Can you read? Can you kill?
Get in line. I got first dibs, little weasel.
Why
are
you doing this to Tanya? Is she not your favorite comrade? Does she not get you free tickets to Porky and Bear?
Maybe that's why I did it to you.
Well, if you could want yet another nose job, I'm more than willing to arrange. What are you, little ghost? Can you not dress like a normal human being for what?
I was leaving alone. You can't help me telling you lousy
job. Lousy job? What are you calling a lousy job? Something that does a deep six while you're playing it?
Thanks, Mr. Literature. My career is over.
Oh, and what's that, like the third time this month?
For your information, I got a part today in a play on Broadway with Catherine Hepburn. So shut up!
You were in a play with the Katerina Hepburnovia? What did you do, Miss Gislintar?
Are you going to stand there and let her talk to me like this?
I didn't know. I was in the room and I loved the conversation.
Why ask him for help? He's the one who said these terrible things about Tanya. Maybe I wish she was not to understand the way she does.
Oh, Tanya, shut up. Most of the stuff he wrote about you is true.
Oh, great. The boys are freezing for a guy in the title power and blood and shame.
Oh, what is that supposed to mean, huh?
And if it wasn't for you,
go back.
Huge.
your number, Phil. I've been meaning to tell you for quite some long time that your comments on my job have really been annoying me. And that Camille act that you put on every time you lose a job.
Camille act?
Yeah.
How about the times I've had to sit up with you after you've been canned, which, not that you're keeping score, is a lot more frequently than the times you had to bite the bullet with me.
Bite what bullets? You bite pizzas.
Oh, yeah?
Oh, now there's a sin link about comeback.
The two of you are nothing. Face to back. You can only be hurt if you have legitimate talent. Phil and Mika, you are a dime a dozen with inflation. Marshall, he can be replaced by something in a grocery store. Tanya and her legs have true and deep gifts. Therefore, Tanya and her legs can only be offended.
Tanya, my little Pisgah, the ability you have to sit the way you do does not make you the next Martha Graham.
As a matter of fact, it doesn't even make you the last Martha Graham. Can't you just schlep into a world with a normal human being for once?
I know. Every time you come in, it's like St. Petersburg in 1906. I expect that they didn't see the Tsar follow you in.
Are you hearing how they talk to Tanya?
Oh, knock it off. I think what I'm trying to say here is Michael has a point.
Of course I did. And, I mean, you all have these faults, but because we're friends, we can grow and learn from them. I think that these honesty talks are very helpful.
I don't think you're gonna push this too far.
Let me get this straight. You feel that basically we're your friends, but like all other human beings, we have these annoying little traits.
Yeah.
And since you're the Methodist St. Francis of Assisi, you thought it was your responsibility to point it out to us. Only you couldn't do it any other way than because you felt it was the only way to compete.
Yeah.
You're supposed to benefit from what you've done and thereby grow as human beings.
Something like
that. Thus becoming, in the long run, better characters. Now, with every younger, we should be grateful for your tremendous human service.
Yeah, see, I knew that what you thought about
then
it.
Then why do I feel for being canned?
My family!
What do you mean, our fault? Who do you think you are, Pope Michael?
Yeah, there are a few things you do that get on my nerves. Like that 3 a.m. typing jack you go on periodically. On the nights when romance is in my apartment, it really cramps my style.
How often can that happen? Let's get down to the heart of the matter. For someone who's elevated plans to a lifestyle, you certainly do throw a lot of rocks.
Look, Phil, I was just trying to show you.
No wonder the Midwest has its old rep. Your personality consists of two moods, indifferent and totally aloof. You can't even have even fight with a person. Nothing ever gets under your skin. If you want to get back to someone, you have to write again.
Well, I guess we're not all so fortunate enough to have a Mediterranean background, Phil.
Ew, back off, folks.
Oh, and look who's talking.
Oh, that's right. Slaying me with snappy dialogue. You are boring me, Caldwell. This is how you used to fight with Cindy.
Cindy. Wait, who's Cindy? You leave Cindy out of
here. No, wait. Who is Cindy?
You have not the blood out of Michael's torn Midwestern past. Cindy is the woman in his life. They were fighting out of, Saturday morning car washes.
Gee, I always wonder what happened to Sandra D.
Look, Phil, I'm really getting annoyed.
I'm really getting annoyed. God, Michael's Pete.
Cheesy crackers, Phil hacking each other. I don't see little puffs of smoke coming out of his ears.
Yeah, well, give me a minute.
Are you gonna stand there and take this? Phil, give me an award for my
here. I know.
Here.
Come on, bring it up. Punch me, Phil. Punch, Phil.
Pastrami.
Tony Bennett or Frank Sinatra?
Tony Bennett, but I don't understand.
Okay, are you ready? Here's the third one. The real clincher. For the name of my firstborn son, what would you choose?
Mario.
Are you willing to do that in writing?
I'm willing to do anything if it means ending this conversation. Even this.
I still think of...
You really do talk too much.
Please remain in your seats for a special presentation. Miss Hughes, will you please come to the stage?